What is going on, guys? Welcome back, and today we're going to cover the first prestige of Modern Warfare Remastered, along with the class setups I've been using in S&D to try to do well, get some kills, and overall succeed within the game. First, let's go over the stats really quick. A little over 1,400 kills. I got the prestige around 18 hours. In an hour and a half, I got a few more levels, but around 18 hours. We have about a 70% win ratio. SPM is 700 because the score per kill in S&D is 500. So it's about a kill and a half per minute, a little under that. 20% accuracy, 200 games played, which is a lot of games actually to prestige now that I think about it. But it's been fun, so I don't regret it at all. Leaderboards really quick. Overall, we're pretty high up. 4,200 is not bad. Top 1% out of the 1.6 million players that have been playing the game. You can also look at specific leaderboards, and all I have played is S&D. So if I go down to S&D, I'm probably top 200-ish. Yeah, 212. That's not too bad either. I'll continue to play pretty much every night on stream and hopefully raise that up a bit. A lot of people are outpacing me right now. I'm surprised. Like, this dude's already second prestige down there below me. This dude, holy shit. Like, these guys are playing a lot. A lot. And there are ways to level up quicker. A lot of people have been asking, how do you level up quick in the game? S&D is really good for XP, especially if you can do decent and you don't play too slow and like make the games draw out a lot. But the main way people are leveling up truly is they're going and playing headquarters or domination, and they're just leaving every game if they don't have shipment. And they're joining shipment games over and over, getting 100 kill games, getting like 30k XP. And they'll just vote shipment over and over if they can. If they can't, they'll leave the game, find a new one with shipment, do the same thing. They're basically just farming that map in those playlists to level up quickly. So if you want to do that, you can do it as well. I'm not a big fan of it, but that's up to you. You prestige already right here. We have one token that we received. We use that token on 3x frags because I don't really need dead silence a lot of the time when I'm playing S&D because I rush a lot, so I use extreme conditioning. And if I get close range, they'll hear me, sure. But if I have to use a rifle against people, then I will never be heard anyway. I'm using an M16 from a distance, or I'm using an AK or something like that. This game has 20 prestiges, if you didn't know. The original 10, and then they went past that and made 10 extra. And then even after that, they have 1,000 levels, which is ridiculous. And we know that because of the personalization. If you go under, is it emblems? No, calling cards. The prestige section, the first one you see is the end, reach level 1000. So yeah, they have a lot of levels in this game to go through. I look forward to trying to do all of them if I can. We'll see. All right, that covers the prestige, that covers my stats. Let's go over the classes now. I would say the main five classes I had were probably the first five. The sixth one is more of a wild card I've been playing with. The first is an M16. I use red dot on pretty much any rifle except AK. I would say I like it on the M4 as well. I don't like silencers, I don't like grenade launchers, unless I'm trolling, I'll use a grenade launcher class for spawn tubes, but otherwise, the default is red dot M16, sidearm is whatever pistol you like. I would prefer the Deagle, don't have it unlocked at the moment because I prestiged. I usually like to rock stun grenades. I can see flash grenades being okay on the M16 because it is a slower class. Usually I run stuns because you throw them faster. Old games, going back to like MW3, I think is when it just changed. You throw stuns much quicker than flash grenades. So the only reason people threw flashes in MW3 was recon. But still, stun grenades were really good to rush with. Perk 1 is 3x frags in S&D all the time. If you can't use that, 3x specials usually helps you get some kills when you're pushing rooms. Not bad. Some people like claymores and bomb squad. Maybe. It depends. It might be okay to have one or two classes with one of these each. It depends on like the game that you're playing. Maybe you're playing against a lot of people that use claymores. Might be good then, but otherwise I like 3x frags to get spawn nades or nade people that are camping in a room, whatever it may be. Stopping power, because that's what I prefer personally. I tried double tap on the M16. It's not terrible, it's just it has a lot more recoil and it's no more damage than using stopping power. So I think stopping power is your best option there. And the third one is a really big idea that I should say is that a lot of people have tried steady aim. Some people like extreme conditioning to rush up with the M16. Some people like dead silence, which is really good too at times. I have a dead silence class with M16 usually. Deep impact though is by far the best perk for the M16 because it just wrecks through walls, okay? It'll one burst people through walls crazy. Like it's so strong. You just want deep impact on the M16. Any other rifle, seriously, if you're using the AK, M4, G3, 36, M14, whatever you want, you can use Dead Silence. It's perfectly cool. But I would say on the M16, on most maps, Deep Impact is better. So going to the second class is a Rush MP5. Same concept, really. I don't really mind Red Dot on the MP5. I don't have it unlocked yet, but I'll use that probably when I do. MP5, I prefer the AK-74U. That's my better gun. AK-74U and P90, I prefer. But MP5 is solid. I'll still use it. It's a really good gun. USP, stun grenades, 3x frags, stopping power, extreme conditioning. Same concept. You're rushing with this class a lot. This is the same class, but instead of stopping power, Juggernaut. Juggernaut is used to survive spawn snipes and spawn nades on certain maps. You can use this. Juggernaut reduces explosive damage by about 25%. It also lets you survive almost any snipe shot unless it's a headshot. So you have a better chance to be able to rush, which is more fun for me. I like to use stopping power, and sometimes I'll rush with Juggernaut and then weapon swap to swapping power stopping power classes. That works really well too. But this class is essentially meant to rush with and avoid one of those two things to die, just instantly die to off the spawn, which sucks. It can also help if people are dick riding M16s a lot and you're trying to rush them, but usually you're going to have to M16 them yourself. The M4 class, this is a rushing rifle class. I don't use the M16 for this. I prefer the M4 or even the AK-47. I love the AK-47, but I've been playing with both guns to see which is better. Red Dot's good on this. If I'm using the AK-47, I don't use Red Dot though. I don't think it helps that much. The gun has decent iron sights, and the Red Dot just adds a lot of recoil, or visual recoil, it looks like, so I avoid that. Same concept for the classes, though, are the perks. The M40A3 is my one sniper class that I use here. M40, I can use Barrett as well, whatever. I'm using Steady Aim at the moment. Extreme Conditioning is pretty good, too. I would say if once I get it, I might use Iron Lungs. I'm not a huge Iron Lungs fan, though. I feel like if you stand still too long, you're going to die. It's usually the case, at least in S&D. So I don't like holding my breath for a super long time. And then Dead Silence is always a good thing for your sniper as well. So I would have Dead Silence on this for sure if I had it unlocked. But I prefer Steady Aim while I'm leveling up, make it a little easier to quickscope if I can. The last class is a Rushing Juggernaut Shotgun. This is a rushing class to avoid spawn snipes. Also, really just fun to use on certain maps. This is the Pump Action Shotgun. Really strong, okay? Super strong if you've ever used this. Really good on maps like Crash, for example. If you want to rush on offense into the house, you can control the house very well with the shotgun. Another good example of this works pretty well on Vacant. So this is just a good class. It's fun to use. I like the shotguns. I figured I might as well use it more because I've been using a lot of SMGs, and it's a wild card class. You can use whatever you want for it, really, but that's my wild card class. And those are what I've been using to level up, get my kills, and try to do as best I can. I've had a few games in the 15 to 16 kill range, but I have not dropped a 20 plus yet in COD 4. Not yet. Hopefully I can do it soon, though. Hope you guys enjoyed. Thank you for watching. Leave a like if you did. I will see you all later. Bye-bye.